Station. This is Houston. Are you ready for the event?
This is the International Space Station. I hear you loud and clear, and welcome.
Hi, my name is Alexandra Masigan, and I'm a WAVE student at Caltech. My question is, what is your advice for college students who dream of becoming astronauts? How can we best prepare ourselves to pursue that goal?
That is a great question, and I would say to college students who are interested in this type of role, this type of career, find something that you're interested in. The one thing that all of my classmates and my crewmates have in common is that we don't have the same background. we all came from different experiences and different career paths that led us to this point. So there's no one single path that will get you here. So find something that you enjoy that gets you out of bed in the morning and pursue that. Find opportunities. To pursue that, find things like internships. Certainly for me, my internships, like the ones I did at JPL and a couple of the other NASA centers, were hugely important for me. And continue to find ways to pursue your goal.
My name is Madeline Young, and I am with BEST. If you could go back in time and provide advice or encouragement to your young self, what would you say?
There's ultimately a lot of things I would probably say to my younger self, but I think one of them was something that I heard a lot growing up, especially from my parents and teachers and mentors, but something I'm not sure I fully believed until now, and that's that hard work really does pay off. There are very, very few circumstances where working your hardest, putting your all into something will be something that you regret, particularly if it is something that you are passionate about and something that you enjoy. So I would say to myself and also to other young people out there, just continue to put one foot in front of the other and work hard at whatever it is that you're doing.
My name is Soyul Reynolds. I'm in first grade. And why do you want to be in space?
I have dreamed of being an astronaut and wanting to fly in space for as long as I can remember. I was inspired by books and movies. And then when I was in second grade, so in the grade that many of you are in right now, I remember my teacher wheeling a television into the into our classroom and seeing the very first space shuttle launch. And that's when I knew that there was a path, a possibility of finding a job of living and working in space. And I'm so grateful to have this opportunity.
Hello, my name is Eli Summers. I'm in the fourth grade. How does the space station get its power?
It's really amazing that that we don't have to get power from the ground. We generate all of our own power with the amazing solar arrays that we have on the outside of the space station. And in fact, we're in the process of upgrading our solar arrays so that we're going to have 6 brand new solar arrays that are kind of layered over top of our existing solar arrays. Each one of those new solar arrays generates about 20 kilowatts of power. So altogether, 120 kilowatts. In addition to the solar arrays, the existing solar arrays, which produce about 95 kilowatts, it's going to be a total power generation of about 215 kilowatts, which provides power for all of the equipment inside, for our environmental control system, and our ability to control the spacecraft in space and to have communications like this so that we are able to share our experiences with the ground.